Hello, Kalibitokilisedi, and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're new, join the crew. If you're a returning subscriber, you know I appreciate you. I've been gone, and you know what? That's a chat for later. So today is a vlog, so welcome to the vlog. And I'm going to the South African Motofest, I think that's what it's called. It's hosted in Kyalami. And I was invited by a friend of mine. Her name is Pukako. Shout out to her. So we're just going there together. A lot has been happening in our lives. It's like our date today. So we're going to be catching up. A lot has been happening in both our lives. So, I mean, like, I know, you know, like, what's been happening with her life. She knows what's been happening. But, like, we're going to, like, fully unpack everything. So we're just going to be on a little cute date. I don't know what to expect. Like, I know it's a Motofest, and it's actually happening this whole weekend. And it started yesterday, which was Friday, and then until tomorrow, which is tomorrow's Sunday. Today is Saturday. So I've been checking, like, on the stories, like, okay, like, what's going on, you know, what to expect. And so I kind of have a swelling an idea, but I genuinely don't know. I don't even know if, I mean, obviously it's like a Motofest, so, like, we'll see cars, obviously, fine. But I don't know if there's, like, other experiences with it and, you know, like, what really goes on. So we'll find that out together as I take you through. But yeah, guys, like, ish, a lot has been going on. But yeah, anyways, it's currently 11:30. I'm set to meet up with her at 2, which means I must be done at 1:30. And one thing about Butako, she is, like, she keeps time. Like, her at 2 o'clock, she means 2 o'clock. So I can't even rely on her to, like, you know, be late, because she will really, like, stick to the time. So I always try my best with her, specifically to also just always be on time, because she's always on time. Anyways, let's get ready. I don't know what I'm wearing. Oh, also that, I just feel like, you know, it's another conversation, but let's get ready.
I'm sitting like this because I actually was shooting, like I was just like doing a live update, right? And I looked back at the footage and I realized that the videos were shot in slow motion, and it was literally 10 minutes worth of content. Like, I'll even put a screenshot up here. Like, it was 10 minutes of content that I shot in slow motion. I spoke, I even did the first step of my makeup. I did so much only for it to all be in slow motion. Yo. As I was saying in the previous video, I'm so upset. There's no reason for that to happen to me. As I was saying in the previous video, I don't like any of my clothes. And today's particularly cold, and I don't like any of my winter clothes. Like, if it was summer, like, for me, summer is a lot easier because, you know, it's like, it's simple, it's easier. I like my summer clothes. I don't like my winter clothes, so I don't like going out in the winter. And that's particularly been a struggle for me, because it's like, I really want to, like, know how, like, I want to dress better, you know, and I want to dress according to the style that I want to dress according to. I don't know if that makes sense, but, like, in my mind, I have a specific style that I envision for myself, but I don't dress according to that style, you know what I mean? So yeah, anyways, I'm so upset about the slow motion thing. Like, I don't even know what to do. Okay, cool. So just as a young life update, I've been okay, you know? Like, I've definitely seen better days in my life and all of that. But, like, you know, life could be worse, you know? I will be honest, though, that, like, in being okay, I've been in a funk. And, like, shout out to my parents. My family, like my cousin, my brother, like a lot of people have just been, like, really carrying me emotionally these days, and, like, I'm very grateful for that. Like, all my friends, actually, like, I want to particularly shout out Jabu, because Jabu and I talk, like, 4 times a week at least, so she's very up to date with, like, my everyday feelings, like how I'm feeling today, tomorrow, yesterday, all of that, you know. So, and even with her, like, she's also just been, like, I've also just been supporting her. Like, we've been pouring into each other's cups, and I appreciate that so much, because, like, you know, like, what look at every now and again, you know, so we've been pouring into each other's cups, but not just her though, like all my other friends, like we've just been like, you know, supporting each other. And it's also like, what I appreciate is that me and my friends, we're all in different provinces, we're all in different spaces, but we've made so much of an effort, and yeah, just made time and effort to just still have that relationship together, still speak, still make time for each other and all of that. So I definitely appreciate that. So yeah, recently on my Instagram story, I asked my followers and I was like, hey, what is a feeling that you've been feeling a lot recently, right? And, you know, I got a lot of responses, and you know, it was all in a different spectrum of things. You know, some were on the positive side, some were on the negative side. So it's actually very like, it was very interesting to kind of just hear out and whatever. But I never actually spoke about my answer to that, of like what I've been feeling, like what's the one feeling that I've been feeling a lot recently. And the feeling that I've been feeling a lot recently has been the feeling of disappointment. Like, it's just you're in, and in so many ways, like I've been feeling disappointed, particularly in myself. And to follow that up, I've been feeling disappointed in God. And that is a whole chapter we'll have soon. But it's just, disappointment has been the name of the game for the past couple of months, right? I've been trying to get myself out of that funk, and I am definitely a lot better than what I was maybe like a month ago. And the thing is, like, I've been feeling disappointed in people, the people around me, the people that I speak to regularly, you know, all that stuff. Like, I've been feeling a lot of disappointment with the people around me, with myself, and with God. I'm not gonna necessarily speak of the people around me, because you know what, life is life, and people come, people go, and that's okay. But I wanna particularly speak about the disappointment I've been feeling in myself, and the disappointment I've been feeling in God. So a recent study, I don't even know if it's a recent study, but somebody told me that August or September has the highest suicide rate, right? And I think it's a world statistic, but generally people are sadder like in August time. And obviously, like, that's just the statistic and all of that, but we're just talking about it, and we're like, okay, but I wonder why that is. So like, why is that a thing, you know? And so we came up with a couple of suggestions or whatever, but like the one thing that we spoke on mainly was like, I think it's because August is that time of the year where it's like half of the year has gone by, and so you realize in August like the year's about to end, and you've not achieved the things that you wanted to achieve. And that's particularly where my disappointment comes in, right? So I'm not like depressed or anything like that. Like, it's not hasi like a case of concern or anything like that, you know. It's just general feelings that we feel just as humans, as life goes on and as things happen, right? I realize that I have not achieved a lot of the goals that I set myself, that I set for myself this year. And I'm particularly disappointed because some of those goals, it's just because of negligence, you know. It's not because like I tried and it didn't work out, it's because I did not try. I was negligent with them and I didn't focus on them as much as I should have. So yeah, but then in the chat of also just being disappointed in God, it's like, it's because like I was like, because I had thought that by this point I would have achieved ABC. But obviously, like, you know, as Christians, you're like, I want to do this, God, in your name, right? And you know how we're like told that, like, ask God whatever you want in his name and you will receive it, you know? And it's like, so I've been like, I've spoken to God and I've had those conversations to be like, okay, so this is what I want, this is how we're gonna achieve it, this is what we're gonna do, whatever, whatever. So I'm like, oh God, come to Tintang. I thought Ribuile, you know, like I thought like we were on the same page, what's going on and whatever. And in me kind of just realizing like this is what I'm going through and like what's up, I also then realized that, like, first of all, in order for me to be grand, I've just decided that, like, sekile happy. Like, I've made a decision to be happy. Like, it's a decision that we've made. Disappointed, all those things. So I've just made an executive decision with myself that I am going to be happy. So that was the first step. The second step also, and this ties into the situation of being, like, feeling, like, disappointed in myself and feeling disappointed in God, was just the idea that, like, you need to detach yourself, or I needed to detach myself from the idea of my life and what I think my love should be. Because as much as we pray and we say that, like, you ask God for these things and he'll give it to you, but it's also like God's plan is always greater for you. So you just need to trust that process. And if the trusting the process, Yamudim, is such a tricky chat, because what do you mean? I just need to trust the process, you know? I'm learning that. Like, I'm learning that, like, as individuals, we need to detach ourselves from the idea of what our life is meant to be. Actually, TK yesterday, I was speaking to TK last night, and she said to me, she was like, you know, you realize that you're actually not in the driver's seat of your life. Like, we think we are, because it's like, oh, it's my life, whatever, whatever. But you're not in the driver's seat. You're actually in the passenger seat. And you can make suggestions. You can try to make directions of, oh, let's turn left, let's turn right, let's, you know. But if God wants to turn left, ultimately, he will do what he wants to do with your life. And so it's kind of also just that realization that you're not in as much control as you think you are. Guys, am I cooking? But anyway, so I am just currently getting out of a funk of feeling disappointed in those different things that I've been feeling disappointed in, and just trying to find happiness in the little things. So yeah, that's just a little bit update, like a little bit of a life update with me. But otherwise, in Sikile Shapu, like once ever, Stegena Solapili, you know the vibe. So Huba Shapu ke Shapu. But there's just those little things that have just been happening that I'm just like, oh damn, like why must this happen? Why must that happen? And the likes of that. Anyways, I'm gonna carry on getting ready, so that I stay on time. And I'm gonna figure out what to wear, and then I'll catch you guys a little bit later.
gonna get you be the jabba. See, I don't get time, I need a bada. Dada cover my face, calling me da bada. Big man, we don't be where I bada.
It's been a bunch of days. I don't even know if you can hear me, but obviously now is rugby time, and you know, rugby time means South Africa comes together, and that's the vibe.
Not running away.
Yeah, boy, look. Wait.
If they touch my phone after the game,
finally
the rising. Taking
down
Matana.
South Africa won, per, and that's on period. No DNA, just RSA. Yo, hey, how do you feel about today's day and like the most of late in them? Yeah, how do you feel about the most of and
oh my god, we are definitely coming back.
Yeah, 1,000%.
Because the vibes are nice, the atmosphere is so lovely.
Yeah.
I just enjoyed it.
Like, it was just nice, it was very chill. Like, everybody's just here to have a good time.
Oh no, it's a king,
And then on top of that, obviously we watched the game, which was perfect because we won. So, Njay, good day. Good day to have a good day, and that's what it is.
This one I actually know.
Okay.
This is hibiscus tea.
Okay.
It's just rectificate tea that you put down.
Yeah, I'm a little busy for that. Oh, but I'm something.
Burrito.
Taco.
It's so wild with this thing.
So he's gonna do the period assimilation thing.
And we'll record it.
And we're gonna record it, and I'm gonna show you. There will be evidence of how he acts. But basically, it's like a thing that you put on, like, and then it kind of like it stimulates like the like our period pain.
As long as I beat him.
It's not about Tepi. Tepi's not even in my... Okay, Tepi's
in
my vlog.
Oh no, T's the highest.
Yes.
I need to
be T. Tepi's not even in this. Like, I didn't get that part of it. So, you're not... You're, it's you against you.
No, I'm gonna do one now. So later on, I do one again to see.
But you must do it now, because it seems like you're gonna start the quiz.
I just feel vibration. Like it just switches my legs.
I wanna try it.
Wait, did you catch that on camera?
No cap.
Thank you all so much for coming out tonight. Give yourselves a round of applause. It's all about business, so I hope that you win.
That's not true.
For one mark, you need to know this person's full name. Full name.
Spelling!
Spelling does not count.
You know that spelling doesn't count.
People ask me just how shit is it in the UK. We put astronauts on the space station.
How about take the food as a time fucking? They catch us on Zoom cheating.
All right, we'll give you 2 more minutes.
My bed for 11.
I think that's
it. Oh, that's so good, Mahlatsi. Mahlatsi's brilliant. That's exactly it.
I said 11's jumbo book.
No. Not 11.
Okay, guys, he's really good. There's words here that's supposed to mean something, right? Oh, shit, these things, all the words are also good.
Which is
11 is game reserve.
Okay, put Rocco Mamas, yeah?
No. Establishment. So, name the
restaurant. So, okay, restaurant.
Number 11 is game reserve.
Okay, number 11.
We'll give you 2 more minutes.
Number 9, what did you say?
Let me join them in my.
my boy.